So, question 9 is about a regular hexagon, and we need to understand its angles. Look at the diagram. What I'd really like to know are these internal angles of the regular hexagon, but they're tricky to get at first. So instead, what I've done is to produce the sides like this. And you've got 6 angles which are manifestly equal to one another. If you like, there's a rotational symmetry for this regular hexagon. If you rotated it one edge to the next one and you did it 6 times, you'd come back to the beginning. So there are lots of ways to understand what this external angle is, but I think quite a nice one is to imagine that we're viewing a racetrack from above, and we're looking down on perhaps a car driver. The car is facing in a clockwise direction, and it drives around the racetrack. Now, every time it comes to a corner, it has to rotate through the yellow angle. When the car comes back to the beginning, it will have rotated once. It's gone all the way around. Now, just as the angle on a straight line is 180 degrees, an angle going all the way round is twice that. It's 360. What this means is that 6 lots of this yellow angle working together make 360 degrees. They're all the same, so each of these external yellow angles must be 60 degrees. So we're interested in the angle I've marked at P here. And the only thing we know so far is that yellow angle, it's 60 degrees. Now we have a whole straight line round here. So those 2 angles, this one and this one, they have to add up to 180. And one of them 60, so the other one must be 120. Not quite what we want, but getting closer. Now, this is a regular hexagon. What that means is that all the angles are equal and all the sides are of equal length. So let's mark that in. PU and UT have the same length. Suddenly we have an isosceles triangle on our hands, UPT, with equal base angles. Now, all 3 angles add up to 180, so this angle plus this angle must be 60. But they're equal to each other, so each of them must be 30. And we've got what we want. Angle UPT is 30 degrees.